Good morning, my dear students. We are discussing our next unit, joining parts. Here we need to convert one fraction into different forms that are all equal. Let's check one of the example. 1/2. We know that 1/2 is a fraction with one numerator and 2 is a denominator. Here we want to convert 1/2 in different forms, but all these fractions are equal. Let's first multiply with 2 both. 1/2 multiplied with 2 both numerator and the denominator. We get the result 1 into 2, 2 by 2 into 2, 4, 2 by 4. And the example 1/2 multiplied with 3. A number multiplied, a fraction multiplied with any natural number gives the same result. 1 into 3, 3 divided by 3 into 2, 6. 1/2 into 4. 1 into 4, 4 by 4 into 2, 8. That means 1/2 is equal to 2/4, which is equal to 3/6, which is equal to 4/8. Here, the four fractions are equal. These three fractions is equal to 1/2. This is the basic fraction. This is the shortest fraction. Okay. Look here. Find another fraction of each of these fractions. 3/4. Another fraction of 3/4. Multiplying with any number. First I am taking 3/4 is multiplied with 2. 3 into 2, 6 by 4 into 2, 8. 6 by 8, one of the form. Or multiplying this with 3. 3 threes are 9. 4 threes are 12. This is the two other fractions of 3/4. Next, 5/6. 5 into 2, 10. Divided by 6 into 2, 12. 5 into 3, 15. Divided by 6 into 3, 18. This is another form. We can multiply with any number. 5 into 10, 50 by 60. This is another fraction form which is equal to 5/6. Then 2/4. 2/4, 4/8, another form. Or multiplying with 6, 6 into 2, 12. 12/4 into 6, 24. 12/24 is the another form of 2/4. Next problem, fill in the blanks. Here a fraction is given on the left side and some numbers of the missing numbers of a fraction are given. Some numbers also missing here. We want to find out the missing number. 3/5. Which term is multiplied with 5 to make 30? We know that 5 into 6 is 30. So we want to multiply 3 with also 6. 6 into 3, 18. 18 by 30 is the another form of 3/5. Next, 5/6 converted into 2/-. We don't know what is the number here. Which number multiplied with 5 gives 20 as our result? 5 fours are 20. So we need to multiply here with 4. 6 into 4, 24. Next, 45 and 3. 45/75, 3 with another number. Here, this fraction is converted into simplest form. Okay, in order to get this, we want to convert this as in the prime factorization method. 5. 45, 9 5s are 45. Again, 3. 3 3s are 9. Here it is over. This is a prime number. There is no other chance. 75 is also converting 75 with 5. 15. 15 5s are 75. Again with 5. 3 5s are 75. Then here is a 5. So we can change this like this. 5 into 3 into 3 divided by 5 into 5 into 3. 1 5 is cancelled from both numerator and denominator. 1 3 is cancelled from both numerator and denominator. The remaining is 3/5. So here it is 3. The denominator part should contain 5. Same as 42 and 48. We want to factorize both and we get as 2 into 3 into 7 divided by 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. 1, 2 is cancelled from here. 1, 3 is cancelled from here. Sorry, it's 3 here. Then 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. 8 is given here. Then the numerator part have 7. So 7 by 8 is the simplest form of 42 by 48. Next problem, write denominator as 100, 10 or 1000 form. Here we need to convert the given number, given first number 1 by 2. Whether any number multiplied with 2 gives as the result of power of 10. That is, if it is any number multiplied with 2, we get 10, 100, 1000, etc. The first chance is multiplying with 5. 5 2s are 10. Same number is multiplied in the numerator part also. So 5 by 10. This is the denominator as power of 10. Next 2 by 5. Any number multiplied with 5 gives result 10, 100, etc. Yes, it is 2. Multiplying both numerator and denominator with 2, we get 4 by 10. Look here, 3 by 4. Any number multiplied with 4 gives result as 10, 100. 10 is not possible. Next, moving to 100. The number multiplied with 25 gives the result as 100. So 75 by 100. Next, 5 by 8. Any number multiplied with 8 gives our result, denominator as 10, 100 or 1000. Here, it is difficult to find out which is the number. So, first we need to factorize for difficult numbers. 2. 4 2s are 8. 2. So, 3 2s are here. We can pair it with 5 in order to make 10 as 5 2s are 10, 5 2s are 10, 5 2s are 10. So, just put these 3 tens in the denominator. Then how many 5s are repeating here? 3. So we can write 3 5s with the number in the numerator part. And we get by the multiplying the product. 1, 2, 3 zeros are here in the numerator part. So we can put 3 zeros carry with 1. Then 5 raised to 4 or 5 multiplied 4 times, we get 625 as our answer. This is the method. Next, we are discussing whether 1 by 3 or 2 by 3 is possible to convert denominator as 10, 100, etc. Any number multiplied with 3 gives 10? No, any number multiplied with 3, we don't get power of 10, that is 10, 100, 1000, etc. So it is not possible. Same as 2 by 3. Say in the second fraction also, 3 is the denominator part. So here also we can't get any fraction with the denominator as 10, 100, 1000, etc. So here the only possible way is 2, 5. If the numbers are with, if we factorize a number with 2, 5, we get as 2, 5, we can convert them into the denominator as 10 or 100. Otherwise, we can't do it. It is not possible. Look at this two picture. Here, one circle is divided into four sections. If one of these parts is colored, then the shaded region should be 1 by 4. Okay, here total of circle is divided into four parts. That should be in the denominator. One part is shaded. It becomes 1 by 4. If another part is shaded here, then it is also a 1 by 4. So, if we want to find out total shaded region, we want to find 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. Here we need to add two fractions in order to find total shaded region. Here, the both denominators are same. So just add the numerator part. 1 plus 1, 2 by same denominator, 4. 2 by 4 should be the answer. else we can either find another way. Here total section is 4. Then here only 2 parts is shaded, so 2 by 4. This is the same result that we get here. Moving to the next one. Here total 8 sections. Total 8 section. A circle is divided into 8 parts. Then I am shading this region. 1, 2, 3 parts. Okay. How many sections I have shaded? 3 sections. So the shaded region should be, 3 by 8. Total 8 parts. From that 3 part is shaded. So that is 3 by 8 part is shaded region. If the denominators are not same for a particular fraction, if we want to add these two, we just convert 8 into 1, or we want to make 4 8. Which number is multiplied with 4 makes 8 as our denominator? It is 2. So 1 into 2 divided by 4 into 2 plus 1 by 8. Here there is no change because 8 is the denominator here. So 1 into 2, 2 by 8 plus 1 by 8. Here both the denominators are same. So we can just add the numerator product. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 by 8 is the result. Another example. 2 by 3 plus 1 by 6. Which number multiplied with 3 can make 6? It is 2. So 2 into 2 divided by 3 into 2 plus 1 by 6. 2 2s are 4 by 6 plus 1 by 6. It should be 5 by 6 as our answer. Okay. Then if we cannot convert or if we cannot multiply to make the next number, what is the possibility? Here 1 by 8 plus 1 by 6. Any number multiplied with 8 cannot make, we make 6. Or any number multiplied with 6, we can't make 8. So from this, we want to multiply in the corner method. That is 6 into 1. 6 into 1 plus 1 into 8. The first numerator with second denominator and second numerator with first denominator. 1 into 8 divided by 8 into 6. 1 into 6, 6 plus 8 divided by 6 into 8, 48. We get 14 by 48 as our answer. Moving to the next one, 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5. Here also we cannot make. So 5 into 2 plus 3 into 1 divided by 3 into 5. 5 into 2, 10 plus 3 into 1, 3 divided by 3, 5s are 15. That is 13 by 15 is the answer. This is the addition of two fractions.